Hi everyone, it's Nancy here, also known as Kitty Scrapper on the internet, and I am back with a podcast for you. I've done really well. I've done my second month in a row, which was one of my targets for this year. So just a normal format of podcasting as normal. I'm going to share a few bits and pieces with you. Got a few finished objects as well and some sneaky yarn purchases. Even though I said I wasn't going to, it's happened. So, first up, I just want to point to the obvious thing in the room. So this is my anthology throw, and this is made using James Make Things, the Kaleidoscope Club. I had several of those and put them together in an order. It's very neon. It's like a neon fade. It goes from a light lemon to this lovely toxic green, and I've just hung it up over my yarn storage because I didn't really know what else to do with it. It's a good blanket, it's a nice size, but I haven't been able to block it out as best as I wanted to. I had to block it in sections because it's so large, I didn't have a space to do it. Could do it over a washing line, but the weather's not been great, so I may re-block it in the summer, but for now it's just making a nice background. Quite often hang up my bits. I've got like a shore wall in my craft room at the back, because again, I don't wear all of them all the time, so it makes a good place to hang them. So yes, that's gonna be in the background. Again, this is my bedroom, so you can see yarn stash. So yeah, it's quite messy and crowded, but it is what it is, and it's the best I could do. Hopefully the lighting may be a little bit better. Not 100% sure, but this is the best I can do, so it's what we're going to go with. So that was a big finished object. I worked quite monogamously on that one, just getting it through. Those last few rows were a lot, but I got there. Another finish to share with you. So I shared with you Mr. Nessie, and now we have Mrs. Nessie. So this was done following a kit that I brought using Fair Isle, and this one took some scraps, and this is from Soxy Nana Alice. She had a scrap, use your scraps, make along. So these are all sock scraps. Not also, actually the green wasn't a sock scrap, that was from Vicky Brown Designs, because I wanted a green for the tail and head, and then these are all opal sock yards in between. So now we have Mr. and Mrs. Nessie. As I say, the shadow is not going to be great in here with the light, but yeah, best I can do. So yes, finish those up. Again, worked on DPNs. Much happier on DPNs now, so yes, put them down there. My other big finish was my twist and turns. So this is the Stephen West make along. Spoiler alert, no, it finished in October, and I picked it up 2 weeks ago. I think it was 2 weeks ago. I worked on it literally, I think, for 10 days after I picked it up and got it finished. So one of the big changes I did is for this section I added a different colour. So I had this yellow, this brown and the pink. To start with, it looked like a JCB digger, then it looked like an HB pencil. So kind of put me off a little bit. And then I pulled out this Pinkie Pie, which is from Kate Celine. And so I picked this out of my stash and added it in to those wings. I've already had this other pink, but it's a much brighter pink. I think this was just too tonal for me. I like, you know, tonals, but I think a shawl all in it was just a bit too much for me. So yeah, I finished both of these travelling cable bits, which I did with that cable needle, done these other long bits. Then I added that Pinkie Pie into the bottom, and then I added five tassels. So I did the brown, which is Odin from what was Stuart Yarns. I don't know what, I think she's only doing yarn every so often now. I think it's generally spooky yarns, but yeah. But that's Odin. Then this is the yellow, which is from Dye Candy. And then, where's my pink tassel? This is a mixture of the cashmere one from Banshee Yarns and the Pinkie Pie from Kate Celine. So I didn't, I did the twisted border, I did a little bit of this, but I didn't want to go all the way down because I actually wanted my tassels to hang free. I've worn it a couple of times. It's quite a nice design to wear. But yes, so that is, oh, and it's blown out the camera, all strange. Hopefully the colour will come back. Yes, so that was that. Is my colour going to come back? Who knows, probably not. Finished objects, what else have I got? I've just got one more finished object. And as I said, the lighting is going to be appalling in this. So, as if you've watched me, I'm really not making socks this year. For myself, I have far too many pairs of socks that I don't wear. So, I still enjoy making socks. And my niece is going to be the recipient of those socks. And so, there is a pair here. So these are a pair of socks. And these are what I'm calling the safe for school socks. So she's only allowed to wear black socks for school because, you know, having different colour socks will distract you from your education. And her shoes sort of come to about here, so you could see. So then I'm going to knit her socks with bright colours for the bottom part. These ones I've decided to call the toucan socks because the colours remind me of a toucan. This is a James Make Things yellow, and this is just an orange. They're a bit more neon in person, but yes. The plus side also making her socks is she's got smaller feet. this is a what is it called? Not changeable. It is changeable. Adjustable. That's the word I was looking for. Adjustable sock blocker, so you can pull the toe out to longer measurements. But this is about right for my niece. So, but yeah, it's a good thing because you can just undo the things, the screws, and do it. And it's a good thing because I can block her socks. Just put that up. Hang that up there. So yeah, I have these Finnish socks for my niece, and then I'm just keeping it in this bag. I've got a ball of I think it's called licorice, yeah, West Yorkshire Spenders signature 4-ply in licorice. So I'm going to cast on another set. So I think I cast on 60 stitches for her. Yeah, I think it's 60 stitches, and then do a heel flap and gusset. So that's the socks that will be on the needles for her. Right, I think that is all the finished objects. I'm not trying to be really, really speedy, but I don't want it to be as long as it was last time. And upload speeds took forever. Right, where shall we start? Let's start with my blanket. So this, of course, I've worked quite monogamously on the anthology throw. I am still working on the Dye Candy blanket club from last year. This was the Neon Fade blanket club. This is really going to blow out the camera. So I have added about that much. I've added a month's worth of colours. So I added the last one of June, and I'm now in July, so it's now transitioning into the greens. I really love this project. I love it. I keep finding other projects I love more, which is a shame. And also, annoyingly, so these are on my Leica needles. These are the pink ones. I've just got needle stoppers on. And somehow, I've got a catch in the needle. They're wood needles. And somehow I've got a catch in it. I think what's happened, I've got it in this sort of basket. I think this is laid on top. And I put something down because it's like a dent. I've been very technical. And I painted over it with nail varnish, clear nail varnish. To try and see if it would stop snagging. But it was just really, really bugging me. I don't want to change to wooden to metal needles because I've knit this all on these, and these are on a 4.5. So I pulled out a pair of rosewood Knit Pro ones that I've got in a 4.5. These are 4.5. Yes. So I'm going to change it to them, and hopefully I'll work on it. Because it's only, I mean, you're not even about to see it. It's like a tiny little dent there. But I just didn't want to work on it. It was just catching. So I think I might make this, might make it that I even just do a couple of rows a day. Because I really want to get it done. But, and as I said before, all my yarn is caked up in here, so I'm going to kind of go on to the blues next. But yeah, it's all caked up, ready to go. So yeah, just really need to work on it. And, you know, I also want to get it done before it gets to summer. And I'm moaning about having a blanket I want to finish and it being really, really hot. So yeah, done a little bit of work on that. So another thing I've been working on is cast on a new project. It is in this project bag, which is an Emma Ball one. I hit up their sale and bought project bags because I needed project bags. And this is called, let me just grab, I've done a thing where I've got my patterns on clipboards at the moment. I had loads of clipboards at work, and yeah, I enjoy just having my pattern there to look at. Just trying to see if I've got a picture of it. No, I haven't. So it is a by Amber O'Brien, and it is a cropped cardigan. It's a DK weight one. And I brought, you can see them like here. I brought some yarn from Hobby. First time I'd made an order from Hobby as well. And I can't even what took me on there. It wasn't looking for this yarn or anything. Can't think. And I saw this yarn, which is, they're tweed effect. I need a new ball. Is a tweed effect yarn. It is acrylic. I decided I wanted some acrylic cardigans for work. I've got a couple of indie dyed cardigans I've knit, but one had a near brush incident with a cigarette, and I was like, at least if it's acrylic it'll just melt. Even if it melts to me, it'll melt. So it is a neon pink, but it has these kind of speckles printed on it. And the first one that I'm doing is this pink, and the pattern has contrast neck band and button band cuffs, and yeah, the ribbon at the bottom. I'm not sure, I think I decided I was going to do the ribbon at the bottom in it as well. But yeah, this is 100% acrylic. It's just a raglan shaped. I'm still working away on the raglan. It is a bit of a slow knit, of course, because you're knitting backwards and forwards. I've got my really cool skull needle stoppers on here. Like I said, they are 50 gram balls. So I'm just about to go into my third ball. And I think that third ball will see me through the raglan increases. And then try on. I mean, her patterns are pretty size inclusive. This pattern is actually to be knit with negative ease, because it's supposed to be quite a close fitted cardigan that you can wear over dresses and things. So yeah, I'm really enjoying it. I said, I think it's gonna come together nice. I mean, you can see where I added the second ball. It's got a bit more speckles on it, but I think, you know, it'll work its way out as well. So yeah, that's one. I have stopped working on it because my yarn is up there. I just need to climb up there and get a new ball of yarn out. Excuse me. I've got the yawns and I've not done much this week because it's half term week and I've slept mainly. But I think I'm struggling not being asleep. Something else I worked on, which I showed you last time, which lives in my Angela Lansbury Murder She Wrote little bag, is this hat. And this is just worked up in a Dragon Hill Studio Yarns. I did change my needles on this. I'm doing this on a 3.25 and I don't know why. I normally do my sockhead slouch on a 3, and this is quite airy. I do wear hats all year round though, so you know, I think it'll work out fine. But yes, I've got these on the new needles, which I will share with you during acquisitions. So that's had a little bit of love on it. It's pretty much round and round. Okay. This next one, which I might pick up and finish as this is editing. So I've got quite a big cotton stash. I went for a stage of buying, you know, the drops cotton yarn. And this one I'm using is Drops U8. I don't know if they even do it anymore. And this is I think this is classed as an Aran weight cotton. But I'm doing the Year of the Dishcloth. You know, if you sign up, you get her pattern. So this is the one this month. It's what are those biscuits called? It's like a lint something in the L. Can't remember. I haven't got the pattern with me. But it's one of the round biscuits with like the heart in the middle of jam. So yeah, just knitting this up in this cotton. I mean, it's a nice enough cotton. I'm actually doing this on straight needles. They're Knit Pro 4.5. So yeah, I've not got much more to do on that. I'm over halfway, so I think I might pick that up and finish that one. Living in another Emma Ball bag because they were in the sale for, I think this one was like about £5. And I love the print with the whales and bits on. So, right, let's share with you what's living in my Highland Q bag, which I got from Caroline. Are you ready for this? It is the start of Bigfoot. So I showed you the Nessies before and I really wanted to make a Bigfoot. I found the pattern I wanted, and I went for a stage of buying brown yarn. Don't know why, don't like brown yarn, but I had to buy some more brown yarn for this project. So this is a Bigfoot's body, and I'm using an Audi acrylic held with a Drops kid mohair. I don't know if it's gonna pick up the fuzz. I've taken a pet brush on this, so it's very furry. you do this kind of loop stitch, this is crochet, you do a loop stitch, which you then cut and fringe for his face. He has got, I don't know if you can be able to see them, he's got gold glinty eyes. I had to buy some big eyes in order to fit them in. So yeah, I finished the body, then got to do two legs, and this body took up basically the whole lot of 125 grams. This is all I've got left with the mohair. The face is done using a, I think I've got it in here. Maybe they haven't. It was a James C. Brett alpaca one. Again, from my stash. It's an acrylic mix. The Audi yarn is wool acrylic, and then said then held with the mohair. Excuse him. And I've put his face like on a little bit of an angle because I wanted him to look like he was peeking around a tree, because we all know that is what Bigfoot does. He peeks around and has a look at us, but we don't see him. So yeah, at the moment he looks a bit like a Russian doll. But yeah, so I just need to do his arms and his legs, get attached and put him together. But yeah, he's been a cute little project, and he will then hang out with the Loch Ness Monsters when he's done. I'm just going to pop him, oops, down there, out the way. So, speed injury. My next project I have cast on is purely the fault of Caroline from Arrowbark, who told me I had to do it, and to go along with Mandy's from Mouses Makes Stephen West knit along. And this is the Vertices Unite. I've always seen it, loads of people have done it. Never took the fancy of it, but decided to, and it's a really, I'm trying to work through my stash this year, so pulled out some colours from my stash and have started working on the first wedge, which is the wedge that goes on forever. Everyone always says, you know, this one takes forever to do. So I'm working on that. I'll show you my yarns. So this first one is from Mandy. It's a purple. Yeah, my lighting's awful. It's purple. I originally had it paired with another colour, which was like a rust brown, but decided to then swap this out for this, which is a Luxury Yarns Sunflower. So I'm striping that yellow and purple. Then my other, I've got two Truly Hooked yarns. Again, these are both from stash. This is a grey with neon pops in and pink, and this is a purple. And then this one is a James Makes Things. I think this is the one he did for his 30th birthday. So again, lots of neon pops and everything in there. I don't know if I'm even going to be able to hold them all together. Why do people always do this? I see people do it all the time, and they always fall. But, yep. They're colours, but you can't really see it because of the colours in this room, but they're all caked, ready to go. And that is living in my Hohe bag. My bright pink Hohe bag, which is now the bag that my Stephen West projects lived in. So my Twists and Turns came out of it, and my Vertices Unite has gone in it. I think that's just going to be a bit of a slow burn project. Not in any particular rush, but because it's garter stitch, it's quite nice to kind of just work my way on as I go. So I think that takes us on to acquisitions. Yes. So it's going to be a much quicker podcast because I've kind of been quite monogamous in my knitting. So I've not worked on lots of different projects, and I've been pretty good at not casting stuff on. Even though I think I'm now going to cast lots of stuff on. So, let me reach over here for a few bits, and then I just need to gather a few more bits together to show you. So, as I said, I had purchased a new set of needles, it's a pair of scissors, I wonder where they were. So these are again in the Mindful collection. I brought the shorter needles, and then I brought a 3.25 and a 3.75 in the shorter ones, and so these are for hats and sleeves. So these go from a 3 to a 6, so I brought those. I love these needles, I love the cables. Yeah, I think I have them all now. I think I nearly have them all. And then I also treated myself to the DPN set as well, and this goes from a 2mm to a 5. And as I've been enjoying using DPNs, actually, I think I can just pop these DPNs away. Yeah, I really enjoyed using these, so it's another set of those. And again, they're really nice. These are all lace tip, and I realised I enjoy working with those. So there are a couple of more considered purchases, but I feel kind of happy with my needle assortment now. I think it's going to work. And with each of these, you get a set of stitch markers and stuff as well. So that's fabulous. Right. Another thing that's arrived in the post is the Dragon Hill Studios club, and this is a bi-monthly club. So you get 25 gram mini, and then 100 grams, and they're self-striping. And as you'll see from the top of the box, this one is a milk snake. You always get something else in the box, and so you've actually got a pattern to make a milk snake. You've got eyes and stuff in. I probably won't make a milk snake now, because I've just made two Loch Ness monsters. So I think I'm a bit done with curvy shaped things, but you get the pattern in there. So, you know, I might need to make a snake for something. But I really love, again, how these are caked up. So the milk snake, you've got like an orange, a beige, and then the black, and then you've got a green as well. Again, I saw this and was like, Halloween, because to me it's Halloween-y, not just milk snake. But yeah, really enjoy these clubs. I've got far too many of them, so I need to get better at using them. Need to make some more arm warmers. I need to make some, maybe make myself some shorty socks with them. But if I do that, I can also use them for my niece's one. But I think I've now got about 10 unused, so that's going to be a project for this year. But yeah, I always like the minis as well. Sorry for the rustling. So yeah, that's arrived this month, so it's quite good because it comes to say every other month, even though I have got a stockpile of them now. But yes, so I have got some more yarn and bits, so I'm just going to stop the camera and get that, and then I will show you some stash diving that I've done as well. So guys, I think the camera angle has moved, because as I was climbing up to get my yarn stash, I kicked the tripod. So yeah, I just grabbed down this is the Hobby yarn, and as I said, it's called Tweed Dreams 100% premium acrylic. So I brought 12 balls of this. I say they're 50 gram balls. So I brought that, and the colour I've got to go with it is this beautiful like teal, again with like the tweedy spots in. So yeah, love that. I then brought enough for another cardigan. And I'm just trying to work out what colours. So I brought the green, which has got like teal bits in for the main body, and then this orange tweed for collars, cuffs, neckbands, etc. So this is more of a Halloween-y vibe. If I like the pop crop cardi, I'll just make another one. When I was looking at the meterage and stuff for what I needed, that's what I kind of based it off. Because I think it'll be a design that, you know, would be great for just chucking on. I mean, not this dress, because this is a sheen dress, but it's got ridiculously puffy shoulders. But it's also got pumpkins and ghosts on. So, you know, I'll forgive the ridiculous shoulders for that. So, yeah, they are. And I, again, because I buy far too much off Shein, judge me if you will, but they make really good bags for storing your yarn in. So yes, that purple yarn, which I can't remember the name of it. It was a February colourway, which is based, I can't remember what it is. Is it crocus? I think it's a crocus. Because it's to go with Denise's Zero Socks, and so that's from Mandy. I also accidentally purchased another 3 yarns with that one. So these are kind of like then her Halloween ones. So I got this one, which is Passion, which is like different shades of red, and then it's got like darker spots, almost like a burgundy and a black. So again, I think this kind of thing is much more of a sort of a tonal for me. So it's a plainish colour, but it's got some interest. That flat colour that I used in my Tristan Turnshall just doesn't do it for me. So yeah, so this one is Passion, and then this is Sky Blue Pink, and I loved it so much I bought 2, because we've all learnt from Stephen West that sometimes you need 2 of one colour. So I'm being a little bit better at that. I actually brought some Bird Street ones at Christmas, and I brought 2 of the same yarn because I think they're going to be a bit easier. And also, I know I'm a plus size girly, but I was thinking if I've got maybe 3 lots of 2, I could always do a striped garment. But yeah, so these are Sky Blue Pink. You've got this really bright, not quite neon, but neon-ish. And then it's baby pink, and then it's spotted with like a blue, but then some places it's like bled a little bit into a purple. Yeah, so I love it. Sky Blue Pink. She has released her colours for this month. She's doing them, like, she does a different release each month. I haven't gone for them this month. They're very pastel, and I'm not a pastel person, but they're beautiful yarns. I wouldn't use them. So that's living in another bag there. So they're my yarn purchases. So there's quite a bit with those 2 cardigans worth of yarn. I also have, like, here, the West Yorkshire Spinners Bo Peep yarn, DK. I have enough to make the Douglas cardigan, a striped cardigan with that. So that's going to be a project as well. I haven't touched my other cardigan that I've got on, my Deception Perception cardigan. But I have worked out, I've got the pattern, found my pattern where I've made my notes. So I've got that to work on. What else have I got up there? I've got my spiderweb sweater. Haven't touched that either. See ya. What I have done, living in another Shein bag, is the plans to cast on another Stephen West. So he has released a new ebook, and of course I just dove in with both feet, and I'm going to make, it's called Fragmentation Shawl? Pretty sure that's what it's called. I may just be making it up. Let me just check. Yeah, Fragmentation Shawl. And it's a modular knit design, and there's some beautiful ones that people on the test knits have done, and so you knit it in panels, but I've also seen people that have kind of just doing the top sections and like working down. But yeah, so it's all about playing with colour. So I went through my stash and decided to play with some colour. These haven't been caked up yet. I think I'll probably cake them up tomorrow. Ready to cast on at some point. So I've gone for high twist sock yarn with all of them. There was another colour I wanted to put in, but it wasn't high twist. So I decided to use all high twist. The first one is from Orchidine Luxury Yarns. And this is May the 4th Be With You. It's a beautiful navy with pops of purple, blue and lime green. So that's my first colour. I've then got Doll Parts by Dye Candy. So again, this has got pops of the green. I didn't want like really like obvious lines as such, because I found out, like I said, I don't like that tonal look. So I've gone all for variegated. So that's May the 4th Be With You, Doll Parts. And then this is Chip, again another Dye Candy, but this is the one which is 80% extra fine merino, 10% banana fibre, 10% pineapple fibre. And again, this is a mint green with purples and different colours in. After that, you jump into, I think actually it goes this way, so I jump into Riot, which is this beautiful orange. Or I might go into Kevin. Again, both Dye Candies. Love it. Kevin and Riot. So then go into a one-of-a-kind batch from Dye Candy. This has got greens, blacks, blues, pinks. Got loads in. So you end up with a very old original. And this one's got a little bit of Stellina in. Called Fred the Yarn from What Must Have Made. So this is one of her very, very early skeins. When it had the label, likes Netflix, dislikes Amazon Prime. So these two. So it will be, let me see. I've seen people like hang them on poles and stuff and do it all professional, but I'm not gonna do that. So it will look, it goes that way. Doll Parts and that. So yeah, 7 skeins of yarn from my stash. This one, and this one have been in my stash for over 2 years. I love them, but they just normally sit in this box behind me. So in looking at Stevens, I think you use literally just over half a skein. So I'm going to have some left in these. So I'll probably be able to do something else. Because, you know, in a Stephen Weschel, he always overestimates the yarns you need. And so I think I'm going to have just under half a skein left of each of them. Most of these, so the Dye Candy ones are all 400 or 425. This one, May the 4th Be With You, is 80% superwash merino, 20% silk. That's 365, so I'm going to have less of that one left. And this is superwash merino, 75/25 with gold Stellina. It's gold Stellina. So yes, project will be to cake those up and get them on the needles. So I think that's everything I wanted to share with you this month. I said it's been a pretty hectic month, been back to work after Christmas. Lots of changes going on at work as well, which, you know, we're all creatures of habit. We all can do without change. So, yeah, it's been a little bit stressful, but getting through. And as I said, I've actually quite enjoyed being get my words out, being a monogamous knitter and getting, like, you know, getting something big like this off the needles is just really satisfying. And say, getting my Stephen West make along from October off the needles, and actually working on it, I was just, it was really nice to work on, and I really wasn't feeling that in October, so I think that really helped. Because I think in October it was just too much, and I'd knit that middle panel, I couldn't concentrate. But yeah, adding in that additional yarn as well worked really well. So yeah, really happy with that. I'm just looking around if there's anything else I wanted to share, but I don't think there is. So yes, thank you very much for those that have come back and watched me. As I said, this is a slightly shorter one, but I think that is going to happen if my plan is to do them monthly. So I'm also hoping that I will be in my craft room next time. Purely couldn't be bothered to clear up enough space to go in there, really. I know the lighting's terrible in here, but it's better than nothing, and I didn't want to put any more excuses for me not to put this podcast up. So yeah, that just leaves me to say thank you very much, guys, for watching, and you know, thank you for all the comments and stuff you leave below. It's always nice to see the comments and the likes. I need to get better at replying more promptly, but yes, that's it. So thank you very much, guys, and I will see you all again very, very soon. Bye.